Hey, everybody. So I'm here in Costa Rica doing a training in authentic relating, and I'm really happy that I actually have two friends in person who are sharing the space with us. Michael and Catherine are sitting with us, and I wish we could see all of you. So welcome, and let's just begin by finding a comfortable way of sitting. And as always, the invitation is to lie down if you're having discomfort or if you're going to be able to go deeper in that way. If you're feeling sleepy, feel free to stand up. And let's just begin with dropping into the breath. Invitation is to, if you're sitting in a chair, have your feet planted on the ground with your spine upright. And let's begin with the invitation to use your own voice frequency, your own sound, to bring yourself into your own body. So what I mean by that is breathing in through the nose, and then as you breathe out, want to invite you to hum. And if you're in a space where you can't make sound, just imagine the sensation of humming in your head. If you are in a space where you can make sound, the invitation is to feel the hum as it moves in your head. And you may feel it moving down through your body, through your core. And our in-person meditators, feel free to make sound too if you want to. So whenever you're ready, breathing in and then breathing out with your closed mouth, breathing out through the nose. Feel the vibration in your body. Actually going to mute myself so that you can hear and feel your own vibration. On the in-breath, breathe deeply down into the abdomen so you can get a really nice full breath. And then see if you can make your voice as deep as possible on the out-breath so that you can really feel the resonance of your own voice, your own frequency in your head, in your throat, in your chest, possibly. Really tuning into your own sound, feeling the vibration of your own voice. coming to silence. Just noticing what's here now in your experience. Noticing the present moment. Is there any leftover vibration still in your body or not? Just noticing. So I've shared before, but that can be a very fast way to drop into your own body. And there's also a scientific reason. It actually releases small amounts of nitric oxide into your brain, thus helping to calm your nervous system. So the invitation is to use this technique whenever you feel distressed or ungrounded. I've been using it a lot lately, and you can really come back to yourself very quickly this way. So we'll do another breathing exercise just to land in the space. And this is the 4-7-8 breathing, where we're going to breathe in, ideally through the nose, but if you're congested, mouth is okay. You're going to breathe in for a count of around 4, and then you're going to hold your breath at the top of the inhale for a count of around 4-7. And then you're going to exhale slowly through the mouth with pursed lips, very, very slowly for around a count of 8. The important thing about this type of breathing is that the in-breath to out-breath ratio is 1-2. So this comes from yoga. It's thousands of years old, and Dr. Andrew Weil has popularized this technique where it's a way of calming the parasympathetic nervous system, or calming the sympathetic nervous system rather, and bringing the rest and digest, the parasympathetic nervous system online. So if 4 in for 4 and out for 8 feels too long for your system, 3 and 6 are fine. If you have any asthma or COPD or breathing difficulties, skip the breath hold completely. So breathing in for about 3 or 4, and you can really hold for any amount of time. It can be anywhere from 1-2 seconds all the way to 7. And then out breath through the mouth for a count of about 8 or 6 if you're doing in breath for 3. And if you know Ujjayi breathing, kind of like Darth Vader breathing, where your mouth is closed, you're clenching your palate, you can do that on the out breath. If that's new to you, don't worry about it. Just breathe out through the mouth with pursed lips so that the breath comes out slowly. So we're going to do this at our own paces, because your pace will not be the same as mine. So I invite you to count in your head. And we're going to do around 8 breaths. And this is a technique that I recommend to my clients when they have anxiety. What I recommend is that they do 8 breaths every 30 minutes throughout the day, that they set a timer. Andrew Weil, who's an integrative doctor, calls this the natural tranquilizer. So it's, if you've heard of lorazepam or Ativan, it can be like that if you use it enough. It can be very calming to the nervous system. And I won't get into all of the reasons why it works, but basically there's a big nerve that travels through the diaphragm called the vagus nerve. And it's in charge of the sympathetic and parasympathetic, the activating, and then the calming parts of our nervous system. And so when we breathe in certain ways, this can turn on the vagus nerve, basically. There's a good reason why it actually works. So let's get into practice together. Again, generally it's 4-7-8, but change the numbers as you need. You shouldn't feel any straining. That kind of undoes the benefit. So whenever you're ready, Just beginning with an inhale down deep into your abdomen, following the practice. Allow the face to soften. Releasing the counting, releasing the breath holds, just returning to your own rhythm of breath. Noticing what's here now in your awareness. Expanding your awareness outwards from the breath to include your physical body and seeing if you can tune in to what's just going on in there, what's already here. Noticing sensation on the surface of the body. Be temperature or your clothing where it's touching your body. Noticing areas of tension, holding or resistance in the body. And rather than trying to change them, seeing if you can just turn your inner lens, your inner eye towards these parts of the body. Seeing if you can bring more of a leaning in, a welcoming, a kindness. Even allowing, perhaps if there are areas in the body that feel like they need some extra nurturing or presencing, maybe even taking a hand or both hands, placing it gently on that part of the body, perhaps one on the heart, you're feeling some tenderness there. Tuning into where is there tension or fatigue And instead of our usual habit of either blocking or judging or resisting, seeing if you can bring just like this gentle, nurturing, loving awareness, maybe through the hands or through the breath. If there are parts of the body that you can't reach comfortably with your hands, imagining that the breath can do the same thing as the hands. And breathe into an area of the body using your imagination. Imagining the breath being directed into any part of the body that needs comfort, awareness. Imagining that the breath can allow there to be more space around any discomfort or tension. If there is no discomfort or tension in your body today, just noticing what sensations are present today. Being with expanding your awareness once more to still include the physical body, but now including the emotional body. So this may show up as sensation, may show up as just kind of a knowing, like I feel sad or I feel joy or I feel anger. And seeing if there is some layer to an emotion in the body. You don't have to understand it, don't need to figure it out. But again, the invitation is to see if you can bring a welcoming presence. Whatever emotions are in your awareness today. Using the breath again to give space to anything that feels like it needs more room or attention or kindness. Imagining that you can breathe literally into an emotion. Maybe there's numbness here today, or a lack of emotion, or a neutrality, and allowing for that as well. Maybe there's so many emotions that it's really confusing and you don't even know what you're feeling. And allowing for that too. Noticing if there's resistance to emotions. If there's a blocking or a judging, and seeing if you can welcome the judge, welcome the resistance. Notice what that feels like in your body. Using hands and breath, just like with the body, to bring extra care to any part of you that's needing it today, emotionally or physically. asking the emotional and the physical body, is there anything you need from me today? Are you needing touch? Are you needing gentle movement? Are you needing to release via crying? So unlike some forms of meditation, this is not about sitting stoically and still. This is about allowing energy, which is what emotions are. It's simply energy. Allowing this energy to be felt and seen and witnessed, cared for, and allowing it to move if it wants to. Maybe it moves through the voice. Maybe it moves through movement. Or maybe there's a sense of wanting to curl up into the fetal position and really nurture yourself in that way. If there's fear here, or there's a sense of wanting to curl up like that, there's the encouragement for me to get your back against something firm, like a headboard or a couch or a wall, to really let yourself feel something firm against the back. Feel your back supported. This can be really helpful when we're in a tender place. Emotions are often linked to younger parts of us, parts that are not logical or cognitive or rational. They're felt, they're in the body, they're held there. Showing the body and the emotions that we're supported through our hands, through meeting our bodies with something firm against the back, maybe even caressing your cheek or your shoulder or your arm, approaching yourself like you might approach a child who's needing your care and attention. And not just with difficult emotions or body sensations, but also with the joy, with ease. Noticing, leaning into whatever's here today. Expanding your awareness again to include all the senses. So not just touch as we noticed through the body before, but any sense of smell or sound. Tuning into taste. Is there a taste in your mouth? Your eyes are closed. What are you watching? The play between light and dark behind your eyelids. If your eyes are open, seeing softly the form and color, welcoming in all of the senses. And also still being with the body and the emotions. So all these layers of phenomena are just arising and falling. And you are in the seat of witness, feeling, embodying, and watching these waves of phenomena moving through your conscious awareness. Feeling them move. Staying with as long as it's alive in your awareness. Finding that balance of neither grasping nor pushing away, but seeing if you can. It's a practice. There's no perfection here needed. Just finding this balance of being with the senses, the body, the emotions. Expanding your awareness again to include the layer of mind. Using the breath as a present moment anchor. So awareness of literally being in the breath. What does it feel like to be in your breath? Feeling it. And noticing his thoughts or stories, judgments, perceptions, planning, all the activity of the mind, including this too in your awareness. So again, unlike some other forms of meditation, we don't have to block thought. I find that the more I fight with my mind, the more it struggles to gain control, the more it wants to be heard. So just trying an experiment of letting the mind do what it wants to do, letting thoughts be here, and being aware of your breath. Noticing a thought or a story, and maybe you get swept away. Maybe you get swept away planning, or remembering the past or thinking about the future. Whatever it is, it's fine. It's not a problem. The moment of mindfulness comes when you notice that you've been swept away. You're no longer in witness. And rather than judging or blaming, being harsh with yourself, which really doesn't work, seeing if you can gently celebrate your moment of mindfulness, your moment of awareness, celebrate, I see that I'm not simply watching my experience, my thoughts. I'm in it. I'm believing it. I'm stuck in it. And then you have the opportunity to come back to the breath. Maybe thousands of times in one meditation, and that doesn't mean you're doing it wrong. That's what this is. We notice. So noticing the thoughts drifting through, allowing them to be present for whatever time they're here, and then noticing as they drift off. Allowing and welcoming thinking, just like we did with the body, emotions, and senses. Seeing if you can just be with your mind, as wild and crazy and busy as it is today, or is quiet and soft and serene, or anything in between, can you just welcome your mind just as it is today? Noticing judgment, noticing perfectionism, noticing wanting it to be still if that's the case. And just having that be part of the noticing. Oh, there's judgment. Okay, what does that feel like? So being with these layers of experience. The rest of the time will be in silence so that you can really go into your own experience of this moment, using the breath as an anchor to the present moment while you witness the phenomena of mind, sensation, emotion, and body. Watching these energies move through you and using your own breath to be with them and to come back to the present moment again and again. In a moment, we're going to close the meditation together with three ohms. If you're in a space where you can make sound, please join me if you want to. And if you're not, then simply imagine the feeling of the vibration of Om in your body. Breathing in. May the fruits of our practice today spread outwards in all directions and help to end the suffering of all beings everywhere. Bow to each one of you. Bow to my in-person friend. Thank you so much for showing up, going inward today, exploring your inner world, being present with the intention of self-compassion, self-nurturing. I truly believe this is the way that we can transform the world outside, is by transforming and alchemizing our own inner judgments, seeing all of our own inner parts as useful and allowed and welcome. It's a practice. Really good being with all of you.